our new teams now, we actually had to write this down because we find it difficult to stay on track. So, overstanding 7, Shiba. That with Star or Heaven's Gate being within, you know. Okay, basically, the inspiration for this was Wetito, the coming out of Jacob from Beersheba. And, you know that word, Wetito, at least from our research, it not only intends to describe a coming out, but a revealing, a publishing, a making known. And so, we seek to make known that which is within, which cannot be separated, for that which is perfect, and nothing can destroy what is, and no outside source can influence it. So now, or modify it, for it is perfect, you know. So now, that, okay, so the object lesson, we actually want to have, like, objectives. You know, after so many videos, we're learning. So now, the Stargate within, through the experience of Jacob. Now, interestingly enough, or much needed information is the fact that Jacob is coming out of the land. So this revelation of having that door within oneself to the Most High, to the Most High's eye, is that the Almighty will be with us wherever, as long as we keep our foundation, our root, as long as we keep true. Jacob is coming out of Beersheba. He's stepping out into a strange land, but it is revealed to him that Jah will always be with him. You know, that one can seek Jah within himself. Our Majesty Most High says, the Mighty Trinity says, first we must turn to the Almighty God, then we must look deep within ourselves. And so it starts with faith. Faith is necessary. We need to look for the true faith. There are many different ways to approaching faith, but one must be able to receive the true faith. Now, we're not going to get into details, technicalities, because every individual is different. And we, knowing our Father, He wants it that way. So now, we're not seeking to establish our idea, opinion of what exactly is the truest faith, being that each individual is exposed to different opportunities, and thus limiting the types of faith that ones can receive. But Rastafari is the fullness. You know, many people say this, many different religions, many different groups, but we this day today challenge anyone to ask something of Rastafari that Rastafari cannot provide an answer to. Rastafari is the fullness, you know, it is what it is. So now, we are not saying that ones can have faith in things that are obviously erroneous and wrong. What we mean is the truth, the essence, the relationship of the inner self of the individual aligned with law, with the universal law of truth. For many, it's different. Now, Rastafari is also different from the majority. Well, actually, Rastafari is what is separated from all existence, from all this world and that within. Because we are favored of the Almighty. We've been given all things. We know all things, you know. Doesn't mean we stop learning. But pretty much questions that people have died for, fought for thousands of years and strived so hard to attain, we just receive without very much effort on our behalf, you know. I mean, blessed be I and I, Rastafari, you know, and we give thanks and praise to the Most High, you know, Jah Rastafari, continually with love and affection and in through Jesus Christos, because that right there is big. That is all, you know. We're not going to say, we're not going to get into this hypocritical role and start saying, oh, we don't deserve it and stuff like that, because it is what it is, and perfection is perfection. We just happen to be a part of it, and we're grateful for it, you know, and we pray that we maintain true to it. For, you know, but personal note, we find it difficult to believe that we are capable of diverting from that, you know, being truth, you know, at least, you know, us personally as Rastafari, but nonetheless, continuing forward. So, yes, many people attain different kinds of faith. For example, you cannot expect, let's pretend there's an indigenous tribe out in some wilderness. You cannot expect them to know, you know, the fullness and the revelation of Christ and his kingly character if he's been completely isolated from all the world, you know, pretending this case to be one in, you know, in reality. We're sure there's some cases like that, but the true faith that connects with the wholeness, that these individuals, although not being able to receive the fullness of Rastafari, you know, we speak of a faith in which at least they are aligned to that which hath been given to them, and they are truly in, you know, obeying and conforming to the principles and laws of creation of all things. You know, that is what we mean. Not to confuse our previous statement by saying that we all have some kind of different faiths, you know. So now, continuing forward, faith is a necessary. Why? Because without faith, there is nothing. There is nothing. There must be an initiative. We must establish a reference point. We must have a point to look forward to and judge whether that which is coming to pass is in fact lawful and aligned with truth and conforms with the with the requirements, really, of existing, of being. So we need a reference point. We now, how can we judge this accordingly? We can witness divine behavior and conduct through the laws of all. Everything is law, everything is orderly, everything is perfect. So there is not a single thing that is unlawful, for then it would not be. And so we can through observation and through past experiences, information handed down from previous generations, we can pretty much have a visual of divine conduct through the laws of through the universal laws of all that is. So now, and with that, we can have a spirit, an energy, and like a burst, a bang, some would say, scientists would say, right, a bang, a desire, a faith, a hope, but really a reason, you know, a reason, a word, a reason. And so one can participate and practice that faith, and then one would have to reflect under reference point. How is this working out? Is this true? So now, that is faith. You know, we are begotten. Oh, one last note. A marker. You know, a marker, a cross, a point to reference that we can align ourselves with that which is true, which is why the exemplary life of our brother and salvation, Jesus Christos is of such importance. We can always see our elder brother and know if we are aligned and doing that which is right. And you know, we're gonna kind of sidetrack, but this is necessary. That is why we must understand how special it is that you know, that the divine will is so graceful, knowing its creation, manifest himself within his creation, that we may know, that we may not have to be troubled by are we doing it right, but not only written down, but then lived accordingly, and then reaffirmed and confirmed in and through the Father, testifying to the Son, yeah, that's the way, you know. And so blessed are we who have been begotten into this world, into this material existence, and blessed are we, rest eferi, to know the fullness thereof. So now, continuing, we are begotten, we are brought into this world, but we are begotten and we are brought into darkness, right? So in the beginning, there's darkness. So there must be something. There must be a reason. There must be faith of something. And so that initiates what we would like to describe as stepping outside of oneself. But in actuality, you step outside the dark self, the darkness, the make-believe self, that which, all the wrong which has been, you know, presented to us as the lifestyle or the way of living. We step aside of the false self, only to realize that we step within the true self, within ourselves, a movement without movement, but still a movement, a motion of energy, you know, a walking in faith. You know, you step outside from everything you thought was into the true self, you know. And well, we've said this before in our personal experience. We were in a pit, in a dark pit, in a hole. We could say, confronted with death or in death, and nothing to sustain we remember, nothing to hold on to, and so nothing to support life at all. So the only option we had was to hang on to ourselves. No hand, you know, no real hand stretching forth their arms in a helpful attitude. No outside assistance. No chance for survival. So what do? You embrace yourself. You hold on to the only thing which you can hold on to, yourself. And then you realize that you stepped out of that which is not, and you step into the light, which is the true self. At least that was like that was kind of our experience. Things started getting better. So now continuing, this motion, seeking reason and finding itself to be within itself and end of itself, which is the difference between the fullness of Rastafari and every single other type of consciousness. We are an end to ourselves. We exist, and we are. We need no outside influence or opinion to establish the fact that this is always. Bob Marley, Berhan Selassie said it best. You is a Rastafari from creation. You know, that's one of the differences. Maybe we'll go into some detail as to how to explain that really. But, okay, so going forward, we'll see what comes to pass. So now, this is a type of the spirit moving upon the faces of the waters, right? This moving within oneself, stepping out of the false self, moving within the true self, you know, nonetheless, movement and action. The simple fact that there is movement and action establishes the fact that there is law and order. So that is needful to keep in mind. So now going forward, spirit moves over upon the face of the waters, moving in an end to itself. You know, Exiabhev, the supporter that supports, that is, you know, the self-existence. So now, objective movement. So now this begins a pattern of objective movement, a birth, you know. But this birth is not one of a begotten status. This is, we choose to describe it as unbegotten, as the initial stages of becoming, formed and shaped to the image and likeness of our Creator, you know, aligned lawfully, orderly with the divine will, you know. And so continuing, now this reference point that we chose to establish, that is needful, because without a reference point, how can you judge anything? You need a beginning. And so another way to explain this, and for certain reasons it is necessary that we include this manner in which to describe it, we'll get into details. Hopefully this reasoning will explain itself. But now, a point of origin. This reference point can very well be accepted as a point of origin, a prime mover, you know. We did not fully overstand when His Majesty said that, but during the Lutheran Christmas special interview, but there is made mention of the prime mover. So now, continuing this spirit, this movement, objective movement towards a lawful, orderly existence, you know, and along the way being formed and shaped, you know, this humiliation or humbling thyself, you know, and allowing the universal divinity to do that which is right, you know, accepting the law, and us being humbled and saying, it's all you, Jah, you know, it's all you. This conformity. We forgot what we were even saying. Continuing. Yeah, that's how our mind thinks, you know. So now, this point of origin, prime mover, this, you know, we being a vessel, we've even recorded this before. We become a vessel. The spirit moves upon the face of the waters, and we bow down to Him who guideth I and I, who driveth I and I, and steered our way through His exemplary life, shaping and forming ourselves, you know, to His liking, to His likeness, and to His image. So now, we go on forward, and now, another thing, this triune partite existence, Trinity, is in a very real sense a kind of like a check and balances system. Check and balances, you know. We cannot have faith in that false self. We need something else. But we cannot, if we are to be self-existing, you know, we cannot be influenced by any outside or exterior force. And so we must rightly check and balance ourselves by humbling this humiliation and conformity to that which is real and true, and which is aligned with the stepping out of yourself, but not really stepping out of yourself, only finding your true self. That is, if you are to be of truth, then that hath always been in you, you in it, and, you know, so on and so forth. So now, let us go forward. We step outside the self. We step within the true self. And now we have the forming and the shaping of I and I to the image and likeness of our Creator. Our Father begins to build a really nice cross, a geometric figure. However the figure is coming about, that is the divine attitude making its will, imposing its will upon this formation, you know, seeking to be made whole and thus manifested as real, as true. So now we have a motion to all directions from this reference point of origin. Now, this movement, now that we have become subjected to the divine will, we must become lenient and flexible that our Creator may, you know, blow us into whatever direction it is that He wants us to be blown into. And this is the process of forming a cross, of forming a man to the likeness and image of his Creator, of our Father, our Majesty, and his Son, Yeshua, the Son of the Living God, you know? And so, there's a reason why we're actually including some of these details that don't really, we assume that might not really be all that clear, right? But like we said, we pray that this these kind of ideas be explained within themselves, being true of themselves, you know. So now going forward, we have the spirit, the divine will, working for 6 days, right? Now it just so happens that once the work approaches or fulfills the sixth day, there's no more that motion can do in traveling from its point of origin in equal distance to all possible locations. We hope that sounds reasonable, you know. The spirit can move up and down, east, west, north, and south. Aside from that, the spirit is fulfilled, is complete. Once it acquires or attains movement to all these six directions, it has exhausted the possibilities of energy and motion to equally distribute itself from its point of origin, from the reference point. So now this brings us to the seventh day, the rest. Once 6 days of work are fulfilled, all possibilities are impressed upon creation, and the seventh day is rest, for it is an automatic manifestation, a connecting of dots, of points. The will has made itself evident. It has forced its divine will upon its own creation, being self-sufficient, perfect. It becomes fulfilled. It becomes a completion, a manifestation. We're pretty sure that this works for all kinds of creation, from the smallest atoms to the biggest, you know, like whatever's out there in the skies and stuff. We're sure that it works this way. Once all possibilities are exhausted as far as energy and movement in that which is being created and formed and shaped, then becomes a manifestation of that which is hath been worked on for 6 days or for the amount of travel that is possible, equally, equal with equal distance in law and perfection in an orderly fashioned manner. So now, so exhaustion of all possible manifestations of motion energy from it from self results in seven Shiva, in an oath in the law. So now that's kind of like what we were trying to explain, like, because we personally we've heard like, oh, seven is a number of perfection and this and that, but I mean really, we know what perfection is kind of, but that really didn't explain much, and this probably doesn't explain a whole lot more than that, but at least it'll give us a visual and we'll actually include the visual, which is why we've been kind of like kind of strict on what we want to say so that they match up the visuals. And so, the fulfillment, the queen of the south, the queen of Saba of Sheba, shall rise up in judgment and judge that was which is according. So one must reflect to the point of origin, and then the fulfillment will in fact judge. It'll she came from the most remotest places. Actually, when scripture indicates that, it means high up. It doesn't necessarily have to mean from the ends of the earth. It doesn't have to mean that oh, she came from the Americas and stuff like that. What it really means, it means that from the most remote, from the most separated from earth. Really, if I mean even just a dictionary, Webster's, Merriam or whatever it's called, dictionary, you could just by looking up the words, it that's what it actually is trying to indicate. So now continuing, that was kind of beside the point, but still it's kind of like within the topic. So now the completion, the fulfillment, this is an obvious well, an obvious testimony and it's self-evident that law governs. There's law within all things, and as soon as we get it, as soon as we just completely accept it for nothing else can be, things get better. You just have to accept it. It can't be any other way. So now for us Rastafari, this is actually extra special because all things, I mean, there's certain levels, some levels have been fully filled as far as the manifestation of the sun upon earth, his sacrifice that we may have this opportunity that we are exercising this very moment to the coming of Christ in his kingly character in glory, which the world has missed. But it only few to few hath it been given. Just last night we thought to ourselves, personally interacting with another being, we have yet to encounter or meet a person whom hath received even a small portion of what we as Rastafari have been given. And then we thought to ourselves, whoa, how many like us are out there? Like, very, very few. So blessed be we, and, give all thanks and praise to the Most Highest I. So now, continuing, yeah, that if we stick to that meditation, we'll just be trapped in the excellence of all. So we got to go forward, right? It is what it is. And so continuing, let's see, observation of these patterns reveal divine character. It is the spirit. The spirit is the personality in all things. showing itself to be so. So now, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, we see all these manifestations. And thus, we increase and better our relationship with truth, with the self, with the true self, and thus establish this blessed relationship with our Father and His Son, our brother, and salvation, Yeshua, the Mashiach, you know, the Christ. So now, well, an extra point to this would be, if anyone happens not to be Rastafari, we would encourage ones to just study up on the life of His Majesty. We've said this before, if you don't want to accept Him to be that which He is, study up His life, you know, the man. Just, we are sure that ones cannot learn from a better example than Him. We're not trying to pressure anyone to accept the truth, but just learning the life and progress and the life of His Majesty Ali Selassie I and Ethiopia's progress, just doing a little bit of study on that, we assure you that'll just elevate you, hopefully to a position where you might be interested in receiving truth, you know. But and we've said this to someone and they plain out just yelled at us, don't you understand that we don't all have to believe he said something like, really like serious, like, we don't all have to, we can all believe different things, or we don't all have to believe the same thing, or something like that. And we answered, you're right, yeah, my mistake for you know, just casting my pearls amongst the swine, right? But after reflecting that communication, we realized he just confessed. He accepted, you know, his subconscious basically accepted everything you're saying is true. We don't want to hear it. So that was kind of comforting in a sense that, well, actually, not too special, because once if you're in tuned with what needs to be in tuned, I'm not here to say I can explain it all that well, but when you're there, you know that everyone, at least personally, whenever we speak to people, they know that we're not lying. They know truth. And thus they hate us, right? But they just block themselves from seeing it or pretend it never happened. But that's actually funny. It's like when we walk around this existence, we see subconsciousness. Well, zombies, really. But yeah, definitely, whenever Rastafari speaks, everyone knows it's true. But they just, you know, for whatever reasons, nonetheless. And we say this to encourage people. You know, one of the best examples of Yeshua, Jesus Christos, is that he taught us how to walk. You know, not only, you know, we say walk, but this individual, our brother, our beloved brother, you know, or we beloved of him, you know, he had an attitude. No one dared step out of line with him, you know. He teaches us and shows us, even though he wasn't the richest, most handsomest, most liked individual, no one dared mess with him. He walked firm, and everything he said was what was, and so everyone had to just shut up, leave, accept it, or just completely go crazy in denial, you know. So we Rastafari must stand up and you know, demonstrate that strength. At least personally, there is no fear in I and that, you know. No one has ever even came close to even trying to say something. It's that simple, you know. We were about to say we ain't special, but we are. You know, we're favored. We are the apple of Ja'ai, you know, and so we get to see things. But now continuing, we kind of sidetracked, but it is extremely necessary that when we walk firm upon solid ground. Our foundation cannot be shaken. Believe we've seen people just crumble. And on a daily basis, sometimes we're not even talking to people. Our presence is enough. Just know that. Just know that. We don't know why we're even saying this, but we know the fulfillment, the completion, and so we said it. You know, receive it, those that are able to. So now, one last comment. We got to, we don't know how better way to say this, but we don't want to get violent or excited or, you know, carried away, but we must take it. You know, we must really, really know what we got, you know. Just by knowing, whenever you step out of your house, the world will respect Rastafari. They will revere, you know, it as funny as it may sound. Well, we were about to go forward, but being that we are 35 minutes into this recording, and it seems like the next step is to do some visual concerning everything we've mentioned. We're gonna pause, and and we'll just continue in a part two maybe. We give much thanks to everyone. You know that. First of all, to Rastafari, you know. And to everyone else that just, happens to watch these videos, we're sure that whatever needed to be done hath been fulfilled. So now, stay tuned for part two.